Hope I am audible to you all and the screen is visible to you all. Kindly somebody respond. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Good. So this is the subject we are learning together, computer organization. Now, yesterday we just revised memory hierarchy and all this, but this part we have to take. What I am going to take today is a small concept called as associative memory. So let us look that component here in the textbook, which is there, as you can see, starting from page number 457, associative memory. So this part we have to discuss actually today. So I just extracted the part which is relevant for our discussion in my Word file, and the same thing we'll use. So today's topic under discussion is associative memory. And this associative memory is also called as the content addressable memory. It is also called as a content addressable memory. Associative memory is a special memory. Associative memory is a special memory used for very important purpose. What is that important purpose? When we want to have our search faster, when faster searching is to be done, then associative memory will be used. It means our main memory, which is a RAM memory, if you compare with associative memory, we can say that associative memory is a specialized memory. Faster searches are possible through it. So it is costlier than the main memory. But what exactly is a memory? Memory consists of integrated circuit chips. And how to connect those, all the chips, that was part of your, one of your exam question discussion also, which we are going to look at in the coming week. And how to decode the address, how the memory is connected to the CPU, how many number of ICs are required, all those, how many ROM chips, how many RAM chips, how do we connect them? All that aspect we are anyway going to discuss. But today's topic under discussion is associative memory, which is also called as a content addressable memory, What is the speciality we said regarding associative memory? It means it searches fastly. It searches parallelly. It searches all the location. So it searches the data. It searches on the basis of the data, not on the basis of the address. So this is, these are three, four key points which you should always tell others. So hopefully you are listening to me. The class is listening to me. Are you there? Are you all listening to me? One or two people can say yes so that I can move further. Are you listening?
Yes,
are you with me? Good. So the key points I'll repeat of associative memory. It is also called as CAM, content addressable memory. It is a faster memory. It is for faster search, basically. It has a specialized purpose of faster search. It is costlier than the RAM memory. It does searches parallelly at all the memory location. On the basis of the data and not on the basis of the address. not on the basis of the address. Now, here the associative memory will be used for what? Same purpose, for reading as well as for writing. So if we have written data in the associative memory, so let us say some part of the data is invalid, some part of the data is invalid, or some part of the associative memory is empty, some part of the associative memory is empty, or some part of the associative memory locations are invalid. At such locations, you can overwrite the data whenever write operation needs to be performed. So you'll be performing your read operations and you'll be performing your write operations. Whenever you'll be performing your read operations, the output is given. Whenever you'll be performing the write operations, input is given. So basically, this diagram which you are seeing, this is the block diagram of associative memory. So let us just closely look at this diagram. Just absorb this. Take a few seconds to look at the contents of this block diagram. Yeah, so we'll go very slowly. How many registers are visible here? So I have argument register named as A. I have key register named as K. I have a match register named as M. So you have A, K, M. These are the three registers. Which are the three registers? Argument register, key register, and match register. Argument register, key register, and match register. What is this? This is actually our associative memory. So what will be present here? Our data will be present here. Let us say you create many files, many programs, many things. So all that will be stored, let us say here. Okay. So what is the purpose of associative memory? The purpose of associative memory is to search. Is to search and that to search very fastly. Let us say I save here all the marks of your class. Computer organization subject, quiz 1 mark, quiz 2 marks, some other marks, that mark, that mark. So if I want to find out marks or performance of some student, it means I have to do searching. Where I have to do searching? Because the content is here in the memory, in this associative memory, I have to do the searching here. Okay. So in this memory, the memory has locations, addresses. How many addresses are there? M number of addresses are there. It means M locations are there. M words are there. So what is the meaning of this M? So M indicates the M number of locations in this associative memory. M number of words in this associative memory. Per location, per word, we can have n number of bits which can be stored. That is fine. Now, let us say I want to search marks of Pujita. I want to search marks of Nisha or marks of Sai. So it means that search string will be given in the argument register. Okay. So the search string can be partial or the search string can be complete. The search string can be partial or the search string can be complete. Who will be deciding that whether the search string should be partial or whether the search string should be complete? That will be decided by the key register. That will be decided by the key register. Okay, that will be decided by the key register. So, how the corresponding bit is 1? The corresponding bit is 1. Okay, so the number of bits which are 1, that this part actually will be explained with an example below. But just now remember that this key register will be the decider. This key register will be decider how many number of contents of the search string are to be taken. That will be told by the key register. Hopefully I am clear. Assume that this is a Google search you are making here. Let us say you put here Pujita. So whatever search string is to be given, you are giving here in the argument register. Pujita, you are writing here. Or you are writing Sai, or you are writing somebody else. So basically you are writing the search string here. So, but what part of the search string is to be taken? Only 2 letters, 3 letters, 1 word, 2 words, 3 words, or complete string is to be taken? That will be decided by the key register content. Hopefully I am clear to you. Now, once that is decided, now let us say the key register says that from Pujita take only 2 letters PU. Take only 2 letters PU for search. Now PU, these 2 letters will be searched parallelly in the entire part of the associate memory. So there will be a response to this. What will be the response? The search response. What search response will happen? The search response which will happen is either the search is successful or the search is not successful. Matching has happened or matching does not happen. Okay. So wherever matching has happened, it means we have identified Pujita successfully here. So the matching register, the match register will be set to 1 to the corresponding location of Pujita, here. So this is how your associative memory will be used. For searching, It means how we are searching. We are searching based on the data. We are not searching based on the location. We are not searching based on the address. We are not searching based on the location. How we are searching then? We are searching based on the data. Hopefully till now you are listening very carefully and understanding it. So did you understand whatever I discussed till now? One or two responses? Yes, no? You want me to repeat? What do you want? Yeah? Yeah. Saket is saying it is clear. That's great. Thank you, Saket. So once this is clear, we'll go further now. Let us look at this example. Now, somebody tell me what is the meaning of this A and K. Anybody in the class wants to tell what is the meaning of this A and K? Okay, I'll show you this diagram now. Now tell me what is A and K, somebody, by just looking at this. What is A and what is K?
Register.
Okay. A register is for what purpose?
argument.
Yeah, but here what we pass, whatever is to be searched in the memory, let us say in my memory here, all the student performance parameters are there, their marks, their attendance, everything is there. So in this argument register, I can pass roll number of the student or name of the student. Now it is clear what is the purpose of this A register?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now coming to the key register. So key register K will be whatever you passed as the argument, how much part of that argument, is to be taken, that is decided by the key register. So let us look at this example. Now, let us say this is the argument passed. This is the string passed for searching. So 101111100. So this is the string passed in the argument register. It means this is to be searched. This is to be searched where? This is to be searched in the associative memory. Now, look at the K register content. The K register content, the leftmost three bits are one. So, as the leftmost three bits are one, only these three bits from the argument register, will be used for search, and rest of them will be masked, or rest of them will not be taken into consideration for searching. So this 101 part only will be searched. Why? Because the key register has bits set to 1. Rest of the bits are set to 0. So whichever bits of key register are set to 1, the corresponding bits in the argument register, are taken for search. Where they will be searched? They will be searched in the associative memory. How many locations are there in the associative memory? M locations are there in the associative memory. So all the M locations in parallel will be searched. For this bit 101. For this bit sequence 101. Okay. So what will be the resultant? For there will be word number 1, word number 2, word number 3, like that many words, M words will be there. So for each word, there will be an answer like match or no match, match or no match. So here in this case, we are finding in this small example, word number 2 has got a match. Now, this match register, the match register bit will be set to 1 for the corresponding M word, where that bits are present for the corresponding M1. So basically, you have your match register M word, it has M word location addresses, let us say, and they'll be enabled to 1 if the search is successful. So basically, all the matches which are there. So if you compile all the matches here, let us say I found out one word, then another word, say 100 words. So I can read those 100 words. Using this match register. So I have to just identify the content of the match register, map it with the associative memory content location, and read it. So that's what how your contents will be read. That's how your contents will be read from the associative memory. Okay, hopefully it made sense to you. See here, this is how your arrangement will be. What is this A? A is argument register. What is this K? K is K key register. What is this big box? This is for associative memory. How many locations are there? M locations are there. How many addresses are there? M addresses are there. These are what corresponding bits. So we can keep track of them. By using this arrangement. Okay. So you have M number of words, N cells. Okay. And this is the match register, where again you have M entries, where again you have M entries. That was as far as read operation was concerned. Now, how the write operation will be performed? The write operation will be performed very simply. Okay, so let us say my associative memory dump is completely empty. So what I can do is this empty associative memory can be filled it totally, can be filled it totally at one go. Okay, so it means whenever I am writing, it will act like a random access memory. Whenever I am writing, it will act like a random access memory. And whenever I am reading, it will act like a content addressable memory, wherein the database search will be performed. So the advantage here, it is being mentioned, see here, the address for input can be decoded as in a random access memory. Instead of having M address line, one for each word, they can be reduced to decoder to D lines, where M equal to 2 to the power of D. This is what is your write operation. Now let us say there are few words in the memory which are deleted. There are few words in the memory which are invalid. So keeping track of all of them is the job of a tag register. So what the tag register will be doing? It will be checking the contents of the associative memory. And distinguishing the words in the associative memory as active words or inactive words. Active means valid. Inactive means invalid. Active means corresponding bit will be set to one for that particular location. Inactive means the corresponding bit in the tag will be set to zero. That's how you can keep track of either empty content or invalid content, and then invalid content can be overwritten by new data. So this was what I wanted to cover in a small way today, as I'm still recovering from my illness. But thank you for cooperating, and we can go full throttle from the next week. So if you have any doubts, you can ask. If you don't have any doubts,